Hallelujah. Good day, every one of you hearing the sound of my voice. Pastor Peter Izoduwa is my name. I want to quickly say something that is of great concern in the body of Christ. And so I want to read a passage of scripture to buttress the reason why I'm speaking in this manner. I want to read the book of Psalm 133, verse 1. The Bible says, behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. It is like, verse 2, the precious ornament or ointment upon the head that runs down upon the bed, even Aaron's beard that went down to the skirt of his garment. Verse 3, just three verses. As the dew of Hermon, and as the dew that descended upon the mountains of Zion. For there the Lord commanded the blessing, even life forevermore. May God bless his word to our heart, in our heart. Behold, how good and pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together. I want to quickly lend my voice to the situations that we find ourselves in the body of Christ, as touching the way Christians carry news, push news that has to do with Christians, especially when it comes to men of God who are excelling. Pastor Apostle Suleiman, Johnson Suleiman. To the glory of God, I respect Pastor Johnson Suleiman so much and so well. He may have his bad side, his own weakness. He is not a perfect man. I like us Christians to support this man. Listen, if it was a native doctor or a man from the other religion that are living the kind of life that is living. Or talking the way he's talking, nobody will say anything. I know in this Nigeria, Mayati Allah, men said to the Igbos in the north, we are your landlord, pack your load and go to your place. Nobody says anything. Apostle Suleiman, you want to crucify him because he bought a jet. Fine. Maybe he may not have put it well. And I also enjoy Apostle Suleiman, whenever you are saying something, I know sometimes you just say it from another context and then people take it and magnify it. I'm saying this because of the problem that you have with your pastor, Mike Davis. And I enjoy Mike Davis to come to repentance, because what he's doing is killing himself, he's destroying himself. People will believe. See, listen, the truth remains that the devil is a cunning devil. Genesis 3, verse 1. Bible says the serpent was more cunning. Now, what Davis is doing is to discourage people who follows Apostle Suleiman. And you say you have the Spirit of God in you, saying nonsense. Let me ask you, Mike Davis, when last did you win a soul for Christ? When last? When last did you preach to one person? When last? But you say you still carry the Spirit of God. And some useless Christians, I'll put it, I don't have an apology for that. Some useless Christians will support you for just rubbish that is coming out from your mouth. How good, how pleasing for brethren to dwell together. It is when we dwell together that the commanded blessings will come upon us. Go and reconcile with Apostle Suleiman. You have no problem with him. You don't have problem. The problem you have is attitude problem. Even the way you are talking in public. Even when I went and changed voices for people to believe you. And you say, so when you say it, everybody, because I know some Christians, they are just there for nothing. They don't know what is right. They don't know what is wrong. So when you say anything, they magnify it and they use it for their blog and they use it for their YouTube, whatever, just to make ends meet. We're a hungry man. This year alone, Apostle Suleiman that you are criticizing. For your mind, in your mind of mind, if government can shut down Apostle Suleiman's church, that is your vengeance. That is your prayer. Let him shut it down. Because the way you are saying, hey, who knows him? I will deal with him. I will release video. I will if it is possible, let God shut him down or kill him. You need repentance, brother. This man went to Taraba, went to Kebbi, has done crusade, large number of crusade. People are still following him. People are still following. And you think what you are doing? See, the devil is using you, Mac Davis. Devil is using you. Devil. Devil is using you to discourage the followers of Apostle Suleiman. Can I tell you? I pray for Apostle Suleiman. God will use him more than ever before. And God will give him what he has desired. He desire it. He desire a play. Let me tell you the truth. I used to think that in that light. I said to Apostle Suleiman, go use your plane, go and preach in the north. And he's doing it now. He's doing it now. And I'm happy for it. I'm happy for it. Listen to me. We should be happy that our Christian brethren are progressing. We should be happy. We should be happy. Pastors, come out and lend your voice. Discourage Mac Davis. Wait. Mac Davis, from your accent, I know that you are from Ishan Land. How come you are answering Mac Davis? You don't have a native name. You see how Suleiman is a native name. Of Johnson is English name. Suleiman is still answer. Your own Oga still answer his own native name. But you are doing everything, Oibo. You are talking as if everything is well. You are a hungry man. Go and beg Apostle Suleiman to forgive you. Otherwise, you have incurred the wrath of God against yourself. Repent and stop discouraging believers and stop talking nonsense to believers about Apostle Suleiman. Is he your mate? Were you the one that called him? God called him, he called you, and you messed up, he drive you away. Yeah? Sleeping around. Your wife, I saw the video where your wife was saying that you were sleeping around. Let me tell you why. I've had this in my little years of ministry. When you are speaking to little girls, as a pastor, you are sleeping around. You are sleeping around with them. They think you are doing the right thing. As a pastor, they see you as a man that will not do wrong. Apostle Suleiman did not reveal this thing, but you push your wife to the extent that she has revealed secret that she ought not to reveal. What kind of human being are you? You are giving us the impression that Apostle Suleiman is sleeping with your wife. Meanwhile, you have gone beyond your boundaries. You took your bride price from your wife's family, and you are still bragging. What is wrong? If Apostle Suleiman decided to marry your wife, it's his business. Because now she's no longer your wife. That is the truth. He's no longer your wife. Shut up and keep quiet and stop misleading Christians. Stop misleading Christians. You are a backslider. Go and pray for repentance. I'm telling you, go and pray for repentance. Otherwise, angels will begin to flog you every day as you continue to make your video. Angels of God will begin to flog you. I have not met with Apostle Suleiman. I'm not intending to even meet him in the next 50 years. Listen to me. I'm concerned about the Christians that you are discouraging. That's the reason I'm talking. I'm not talking because I want to impress Apostle Suleiman. No. I'm talking because you are discouraging people who are serving God in that ministry, in that capacity. It's wrong, Mac Davis. It's wrong. It's wrong. Somebody told me some years ago how that a woman came on a one Jewish newspaper that does not have a name and said, I gave Bishop Oyedepo the medicine that he used to grow his church. Wait, as big as Oyedepo's ministry, Winners, you think it's juju that grow that kind of ministry? I told the person, you think that is true? 2 months later, another magazine surfaced where the woman was begging Oyedepo for money. Please forgive me. She was begging for money, but begging for forgiveness so that Oyedepo will give her money because she was hungry. If you are hungry, beg Suleiman to give you money. Give him. Beg him. Beg him for money. Beg him, he will give you. Stop talking nonsense. Say, I will reveal the secret. What secret? What secret are you people doing in the secret? Are you not a Christian? If you were coerced into doing the secret, leave him. Move on. Go and do what is right. What is important in the body of Christ is that you are doing what God called you to do and not spreading dirty linens in the street. People are watching us. People are looking at us. What is your problem? May God have mercy on you. I pray for everyone hearing the sound of my voice and every Christian that this evil discussions of Mike Davis have discouraged. May the Lord restore every one of you. May the Lord restore his sanity on Mike Davis in the name of Jesus. May the Lord bless the Christian community in Nigeria and indeed all over the world. Shalom.